Let's go. And we will
sing. Oh.
Day, and it's a special one. Today is May 16, Sunday, May 16, 2021. That means we've spent the first half of May, and now we're going into the second half of May. Today is the Sunday after Ascension, and this is your LIFE-BUOY today, still in the business of keeping you anchored to the Word of God, to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Letting you know where dangers may be ahead of you during the day and keeping you anchored to all that will keep you firm and sailing in the waters of life. Today, as usual, we are relying on the Daily Fountain, the daily devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion, for our inspiration. And the topic that we are taking from there is an instruction that you be concerned about national welfare. And we are taking our reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 16. And we are beginning our reading from verse 12. Because we are reading all the way to the end, I need to hint you ahead of time that you'll have to read very fast, because we have a lot of stuff to read. So, let's go. I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear, that he shall speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father hath are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you. A little while, and ye shall not see me, and again a little while, and ye shall see me, because I go to the Father. Then said some of his disciples among themselves, What is this that he said unto us a little while, and ye shall not see me, and again a little while, and ye shall see me, and because I go to the Father? They said therefore, What is this that he saith a little while? We cannot tell what he saith. Now, Jesus knew that they were desirous to ask him, and he said unto them, Do you inquire amongst yourselves of what I said a little while, and ye shall not see me, and again a little while, and ye shall see me? Verily, verily, I say unto you, that ye shall weep and lament, but the world shall rejoice. And ye shall be sorrowful, but your sorrow shall be turned into joy. A woman, when she is in travail, hath sorrow, because her hour is come. But as soon as she is delivered of the child, she remembereth no more the anguish for joy that a man is born into the world. And ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy no man taketh from you. And in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. Hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask, and ye shall receive, that your joy may be full. That is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. You will see from all this reading that the people, the disciples that were with him, were being instructed to ask, and that whatever they asked in the name of the Father, they would receive. And this was about the time of Ascension that all of this took place. And of course, if it were you or if it were me today, that a master is going and is desirous of dropping something, and he says you should ask, I dare say you are going to ask for something personal to yourself. You are going to ask maybe what assets he's leaving behind for you, what powers he may be leaving behind for you, something that will help you personally, something that will add to you or perhaps to your immediate ministry. But the disciples were more desirous of other things at that time. And if you check Acts chapter 1 verse 6, and I'm going to quickly read that so that you will see what they were desirous of. I quickly read that. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? They were more interested in the restoration of the kingdom to Israel, not about personal affairs. They had been under the Roman domination for so long, and they had seen how difficult it was to be under tribute, how difficult it was to be colonized, how difficult it was to be ruled by other people that operated as if they were the owners of the land and turned the owners of the land to people like slaves. So these disciples were interested in the liberation of Israel. If you are given the opportunity today to ask of something of any master, is it going to be just about yourself or about your nation, about your people, about your country? And the injunction for you today is that you should be concerned about national welfare. And if you need to be concerned about national welfare, you need to say a lot of prayers. A lot of prayers, particularly for Nigeria, about banditry, that it should be removed from our landscape, that armed robbery, cattle rustling, and all those other evil events should be far away from us. All the evil cases of kidnapping, now even we are having cases of sacking of police stations. These are all things that you should be concerned and you should be praying to God about. I tell you something, when it is well with your Jerusalem, it will be well with you. So therefore, be concerned about national welfare. Let issues and problems and challenges of this country lead you to pray to the Father, so that if we collectively pray, then we can be relieved of all these evil occurrences all around us. Because the word of the Lord had always said it, that if the people will turn unto the Lord, then he will have mercy upon them. So from today on, be concerned about national welfare, even as you are concerned about your own affairs. And when you pray, I can assure you that the Lord will answer those prayers concerning both yourself and concerning the nation that you are from. But for you to pray, for you to be heard in those prayers, for your concerns about your national welfare to be reckoned with in the realms of the Spirit, and for God to have mercy upon you and hearken to those prayers, then you must know him and he must know you. Do you know Jesus? If you yet do not know Jesus, then come and say this prayer after me, so that your concern about national welfare will have a meaning and will have a result from heaven. Say, God, I come to you today. I know that I have been a sinner. I want to give my life to you. I now believe that Jesus is God, and I want to be aligned with the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon me. Rewrite my name in the book of life. Rewrite my story, and let me be called by your name from today henceforth. I come to you in Jesus' name. If you have said that prayer, I say congratulations, because I assure you, he has heard your prayers and is going to grant your request today. Welcome to the kingdom. If you have been part of the kingdom all along, yes, you have everything it takes to be concerned about national welfare, but you must be sure that you are sustaining it. So say this prayer quickly after me too. Say, Father, teach me to be sensitive and prayerful about issues in my nation. Help me also to maintain a daily walk with the Holy Spirit, that we may be able to pray fervently and have results against banditry, against kidnapping, against divisions, against ethnic bigotry, against all that are not of you. I ask for all this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Go out today and be concerned about national welfare, and the Lord himself remains concerned about you, and it will be well with you in Jesus' name. Amen. Are you faithful? I call you faithful. I call you good. You are.